My name is Bengt Fadil. I'm a professor at Karolinska Institutet in Stockholm, Sweden, and also a member of Work Package 2 of the flagship project. In Work Package 2, we are dealing with the health and environmental effects of graphene-based materials. And the presentation that I gave here in Manchester at the Graphene Week was focused very much on how cells of the immune system interact with graphene-based materials, and we have focused in particular on graphene oxide. Based on our previous work on other carbon-based materials, meaning mainly single-walled carbon nanotubes, we do know that white blood cells, so-called neutrophils, as well as eosinophils, are capable of enzymatic degradation of carbon nanotubes. And we also know that this reduces their toxicity in animal models. So we were very keen to assess and to address whether graphene oxide also is susceptible to degradation. And in fact, we do find that neutrophils expressing one particular enzyme of interest, the myeloperoxidase, are capable of digesting graphene oxide. And what was interesting to note is that this is even more efficient than what we see for carbon nanotubes. So this has implications for the toxicology, the toxicity of nanomaterials in an occupational setting, that means if they're in case of accidental exposure, but it's also relevant in nanomedicine. If we are to use graphene-based materials as carriers for drug delivery, for instance, it's important to know what would be the ultimate fate of the carrier and whether it's degradable or persistent in the body.